Okay, so once again, so good morning sa ating pong lahat. So ngayong linggong ito, ang ating pong i-discuss ay equation of the line. So we are now in our week 6 ng ating quarter 1 ng school year 2020 to 2021. So before we proceed to our lesson, so kindly like and subscribe our YouTube channel. Okay? So, in this lesson, so we are going to find the equation of a line given two points, the slope and the point, and the slope and its intercept. So, from the given linear equation, we can determine two points that will satisfy the given equation. Also, we can determine the slope and the y-intercept. So, as the x and y-intercepts. So, for example, we have a given negative 2x plus y equals 6. So, find the two points that will satisfy the equation. Also, find the slope and the y-intercept and the x and y-intercept. So, for the solution for letter A, given the finding the two points, so we are going to assign x as negative 1. So, substituting the value of negative 1, so we have now negative 2 times negative 1, so that will become positive 2. And then, transposition, so we have y is equal to 4. So, therefore, the point is negative 1 and 4. Once again, the value of x is negative 1 and the value of y is 4. So, we have negative 1, 4. And then, if y is 2, this time naman, ang ating inuna ay y. So, if y is 2, so substitute the value of y, so which is 2, then transpose. So, therefore, 6 minus 2 is 4. So, we have now negative 2, x equals 4. And divide both sides by negative 2. So, we have x is equal to negative 2. So, therefore, the point is negative 2 as the value of x and positive 2 as the value of y. So, this is now our two points. Okay. So, pwede pa po tayo mag-assign dyan. Ano po? So, pwede pa tayo mag-assign ng value ng x and value of y. So, ito po yun. Ano? So, mapansin nyo, yun yung value ng yung dalawang points. Yun po. Okay? So, let us have another example for that. Okay? So, once again, ang given equation po natin ay negative 2x plus y equals 6. Okay? So, ito po yun. Negative 2x plus y equals 6. So, hanap po ulit tayo ng dalawang points. So, if x is equal to, let's say, ang x naman po ay 3. If x is 3, so the substitute the value of x, so negative 2 times 3 plus y equals 6. Ano po? Then negative 2 times 3 is negative 6 plus y equals 6. Okay? And then, transposition, yung negative 6, ita-transfer natin sa kabila, it will become positive 6. So, y is equal to 6 plus 6. So, therefore, to simplify, y is equal to 12 now. So, therefore, if x is 3, so we have x, y as the point. So, therefore, ang magiging value na po natin ng point na coordinates ay 3, 12. So, ganun lang po kadali. So, may isa na tayong point. Another one. Sabihin naman natin, if y is equal to sabihin natin 4. If y is equal to 4. Okay? If y is equal to 4, so we have negative 2x plus the value of y, which is 4, equals 6. Okay? Then negative 2x is equal to yung positive 4, pag nilipat sa kabila, magiging na po siyang negative 4. So therefore, 6 minus 4 is positive 2. So divide both sides by negative 2. So cancel na po yon. So x is equal to 2 divided by negative 2 is negative 1. So therefore, ang ating pong point ay negative 1 and 4. Okay, so ganun lang po kadali ang pagkuha ng 2 points sa ating linear equation. Okay? Okay, another one. So sabihin naman natin na ang kukunin po natin ay slope and the y-intercept. Slope and the y-intercept. So therefore, change to slope-intercept form. So magkakaroon na po tayo ng y is equal to yung negative 2x po natin, magiging siyang positive 6. So therefore, the slope is the value of the slope is 2, which is the symbol is m. And then we have the y-intercept as, which is b equals 6. So yun po yun. Okay? Then the x-intercept and the y-intercept, sa substitute lang po natin na ang x ay 0. So therefore, we have 0, 6. Then kung ang y naman po ay 0, we have negative 3, 0. Ganito lang po kadali ang pagkuha ng x and y-intercept. For example, meron po tayong 4x plus 5y equals, let's say, 20. So, ganan. Okay? Di po ba kapag ang ating value ng x, if x is equal to 0, takpan lang po natin siya. Kung x ay equal to 0, ibig sabihin, we have 5y equals 20. If y naman po ang 0, takpan lang po natin ang y. Tatakpan natin, ang matitira po ay 4x equals 20. Hindi po ba? Kasi any number multiplied by 0 is 0. Now, if x is equal to 0, ibig sabihin, we have 5y equals 20. Kasi nga po, x ay 0, so cancel na yon. So, divide both sides by 5. So, we have y is equal to 4. Ibig sabihin, ang ating y-intercept ay 0, 4. Ito po yung ating coordinates. Matatouch niya po ay 0, 4. Dun sa ating rectangular coordinate system. Then, if y is equal to 0, so 4x is equal to 20. Sa substitute lang po. Diba, makakancel na nga yung 0. Then, divide both sides by 4. So, we have x is equal to 5. Na, x is equal to 5. So, therefore, ang ating coordinates or yung x-intercept is 5, 0. Okay? So, ganun lang po kadali ang pagkuha ng... So, ito naman yung magiging value ng a, which is 5. Then, ito yung b, which is 4. Diba? Kasi po siya ay 0b. Then, a, 0. X-intercept, y-intercept. Ganun lang po siya kadali. Okay? So, yun. So, ganun lang po ang ating gagawin dun sa ating learning task 1. Ito po yung ating learning task 1. So, sabi nga, from the given equation of the line, find the 2 points that will satisfy the equation. Then, find the slope and the y-intercepts, then C, which is the x and y-intercepts. So, ganun lang po kadali ang pagkuha ng given 2 points. Mag-a-assign lang po kayo ng value ng x and value ng y. So, kung ano po yung magiging kalalabasan, yun na po yung coordinates. Okay? Then, ang pagkuha naman po ng slope and the y-intercept, so, susulat nyo lang po siya ang equation sa slope-intercept form. In the form of y is equal to mx plus b. And then, x and y-intercept, kagaya po ng huli nating ginawa. Okay. So, magbigay pa po tayo ng isa pang example. Another example. Sabihin natin na meron tayong equation na, for example, 6x minus, let's say, 5y. Then, plus, sabihin natin, for example, ay 60 equals 0. So, yun po yung ating equation. Ano na ha? So, ang ating gagawin ay yung pagkuha, for example, ng slope and the y-intercept. Okay. So, ang ating pong gagawin, isusulat natin siya in the form of y is equal to mx plus b. Okay, slope-intercept form. Okay. So, once again, we have 6x minus 5y equals, lalagay na po natin sa kabila, negative 60. Okay? And then, negative 5y is equal to, lilipat po natin sa kabila, negative 6x minus 60. Then, divide both sides by negative 5. So, negative 5 pa din po yan. Nakasama yon. So, makakancel na po. So, y is equal to, magiging na po siyang positive. Cancel na yon. Ano ha? Yung sign. So, negative 6 over 5x. So, ito yung value ng m, the slope of the line. Okay? So, 6 over 5 na po ito. Ano po? 6 over 5. And then, the value of b, negative 60 divided by negative 5. So, magiging na po siyang positive. Ano? Positive 12. So, therefore, ang value po ng b ay positive 12. So, pag sinabi ang kukunin natin yung y-intercept, so 0b. So, therefore, we have 0, 12. This is the y-intercept. Ano pa? Yun yung y-intercept. Paano naman kung kukunin natin ang x-intercept? So, ang ating pong gagawin, ito yung gagawin nating 0. Ano pa? So, x-intercept, so 6x minus 5 times 0. 0 po yung value ng y. Equals negative 60. So, if y is equal to 0. Kung ang y daw equal to 0, so therefore 0 na to. So, 6x equals negative 60. Divide both sides by 6. So, cancel. X is equal to negative 10. So, therefore, A 0, which is the x-intercept, that is negative 10, 0. Yun po yung ating x-intercept. Okay? X-intercept po siya. So, yun na po yung y-intercept. Then, ito naman po yung x-intercept. So, ganun lang po kadali yung ating learning task 1. Okay? So, sana po nakatulong ito ang aking video tutorial para masagutan po yung ating learning task 1. Okay? So, hindi po. Maraming salamat. At mag-aral ng mabuti para makasagot ng maayos sa ating mga learning tasks.